God gave his one and only son. That was the price God was willing to pay. If you read the story of Abraham, where he's taking his son Isaac to the altar to be sacrificed, he's willing to pay that price to grow closer to God. My life, I think, would be easier to lay down than that of the life of my child. But God was willing to give his one and only son for each one of you. He didn't just give it like, okay, you're going to die, and that's it. Christ suffered. He was tempted, he suffered, and he paid the price for you so that he can give you the opportunity to change. So he can give you the opportunity to become new, to be different. The end of 2 Corinthians says, behold, new things have come. The middle says, the old things pass away, have passed away. We've got to get rid of the old to invite the new. It's already there waiting for you. That party is happening now. You just have to make the decision to read the invitation. You have to make that decision to go in. You have to make that decision to accept the challenge. It's easy to come to church every Sunday and pretend to be Christian. It's hard to go out into the world and honestly live a life according to the scripture. It's easy to go up to the mountain on a camp and be excited for God because everybody around you is excited for God. It's hard to maintain that excitement in the midst of struggle, living life in the real world, your daily jobs, going to school. In order to have a new life, it requires dramatic change, which will start with a dramatic change in the way you think. If you guys want to be made new, start by changing the way your head thinks. Start changing the way you think by adopting what's written. This is your invitation. These are your instructions. I challenge you guys, this message isn't just for somebody who's in here who's never heard Jesus before. This is a message for people who have been Christian for years. We can do one thing for so long that it becomes easy. It becomes whatever. We become complacent. We stop. We lose that excitement. We don't want to become stagnant. We want to be excited for God, and we want to maintain that excitement. If you tell a friend out at school or at work, hey man, Jesus loves you, he saved my life, and that person watches you, and your life stinks, and you're always angry, why is he gonna want that? But if you're like, yeah, I lost all my toes and I don't have a left hand anymore, but you know what, I'm excited about life. I mean, you guys see people that do like those crazy challenges where they're like totally disabled and they go out and they don't let that stop them. And like the guy named Wheels who does like triple backflips on his wheelchair. People say that's inspiring because despite loss, he is still excited about life. That's what it takes to be a Christian. Despite troubles, despite loss, despite hard times, you are still excited about the life Christ gave you. So as I pray for you guys, I want you to be aware of the challenge. I want you to be aware of the new life party. And accept that challenge. Accept to go in, guys. Bow your heads and close your eyes. Father, I pray that you are here tonight and that you're filling us up. That we want less of what we are and more of who you can make us. We want more of you. We want to become like you, Father. We love you and are inspired by you so much. We want to share you, Father God. I pray in each of these lives of the people here, Father God, that they receive the challenge, they become different, even if they are or have been Christians, Father God, that they become a new, stronger, better Christian, Father God, that they are an excited follower, apostle, example of you, Lord. That when they see, when the people of the world see these people here, Father God, that it's like looking at a mirror that is reflecting Jesus. And that's exciting. If anybody today wants to receive Christ for the first time, I challenge you to raise your hand. If any of you today want to rededicate your life, I challenge you to raise your hand. If any of you today want your life to be more exciting than it was before you walked in here, I challenge you to raise your hand. If any of you today want a newer, better model of the person that you are, I dare you to raise your hand. Pray with me as I pray, guys. Father God, we just thank you for the opportunities that we have to come before you, Lord, to praise and worship you, to draw closer to you. Father, I pray that you enter my life more than you were before. Take complete control of me. I admit that I continuously sin. And with your help, I can get over it. Father, be in my life. Jesus, be in my life. Take control. Make me new. In your holy name I pray. Amen.
not too late. It's not too late for you. It's not too late for me. This next song, I'm just going to give it everything to God, with everything, with all our hearts, with all our soul, with all our mind, with all our strength. Thank you.
said, the very form of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results. That man was Albert Einstein. If you want something you've never had in life, you have to do something you have never done. Another smart man, my dad, told me, it's for today. I worked construction with my father, and when he wanted me to get my job done, he would come in and yell at me and say, it's for today. God has blessed you with many things. He's asked you to do a great job, and it's for today. He wants you to become a new creation for today. He wants you to be blessed for today. He wants you to go out and share the love that is filling your life today. He wants you to be set free today. I challenge you right here, right now, to do something different. This is your time of freedom. No one here will judge you. Dance.
You guys ready to sing my song, Scott?